This video will demonstrate amalgam polishing on a typodont. An amalgam can be polished 24 hours after placement. Here is an unpolished amalgam on the left, compared to a polished one on the right. Polishing amalgams will create a smooth cavo surface margin, reduce biofilm retention, resist tarnish and corrosion, and increase the longevity of the restoration. An abrasive greenstone or a large round burr can be used to prepare the surface for polishing. A rounded end is preferable to avoid putting grooves in the occlusal surface of the amalgam. The burrs we use are latch type. Latch type burrs require a contra-angle attachment on the slow speed handpiece. Place the burr in the contra-angle and twist until it is fully seated. Close the latch to hold the burr. Tug on the burr end to ensure it is held fully in place. This is to ensure that the burr does not come out in the patient's mouth while working. We will be using the Shofu amalgam polishing system. There are points and cups in three stages of abrasiveness. The points and cups are called brownies, greenies, and super greenies. They will be used in this order, with the most abrasive brownies used first. Examine the amalgam restoration with an explorer to detect any rough surface anatomy or margin defects. If the restoration has a rough surface, use the green stone to smooth out the defects. Care must be taken not to put too much pressure on the amalgam, because friction will cause heat buildup. The critical temperature for pulp damage is 140 degrees Fahrenheit. On a patient, rinse frequently with the air-water syringe to cool and clean the surface. When using a typodont, use wet gauze. The amalgam surface should be smooth, free of defects, and have a shiny appearance. There should be no voids or dull areas. Remove the green stone and insert the brownie point. Apply moderate pressure with the brownie point to polish the grooves on the occlusal surface. Rinse the surface to cool and to clean. On a patient, this would be done with the water syringe. Use the brownie cup to polish the cusps and interproximal surfaces. Flare the edge of the cup on the cusps and interproximally if needed. Rinse the surface to cool and to clean. Insert the less abrasive greeny point and polish the grooves on the occlusal surfaces. Rinse with water to cool and to clean. Insert the greeny cup and polish the cusps of the occlusal surfaces and the interproximal surfaces if needed. Rinse the surface with water to cool and to clean. The super greenies have a yellow band on the shank. Use the super greenie point to polish grooves on the occlusal surfaces. Rinse the surface with water to cool and to clean. Use the super greenie cup to polish the cusps of the occlusal surfaces and the interproximal surfaces. Rinse with water to cool and to clean. Inspect the surface for a high glossy shine that should look like a piece of aluminum foil. The finished amalgam should be smooth and have no visible scratches or rough margins.